Hello and welcome to the training video, where we'll dive into the exciting world of mastering HTML signatures. Have you ever wondered how to create professional and clickable links in your email signature? Well, today we have all the answers for you. Let's start by understanding why HTML signatures are essential in professional communication. You may have noticed the limitations of image-only signatures, which can be quite restrictive. You can't add links anywhere. You can see two examples of image-only signatures created in Canva on the screen right now. Now, let's discuss the benefits of using HTML signatures with clickable links. With HTML signatures, you can enhance your signature with interactive elements that make it easy for recipients to connect with you or your business. All right, so to get started, let's walk through the process of creating an HTML signature using the user-friendly ByBrand editor. So let's begin by creating a new email signature based on a pre-created template. Now, to do this, we are going to simply head over to the ByBrand dashboard that we're on right now, and we are going to click on Create from Template down here underneath Email Signatures. So let's go ahead and click on that now. Then we can go ahead and choose one of these templates to go with. So I'm going to go ahead and choose the first one, and I'm going to click on Choose This. And once I do that, that's going to load up that signature for me inside of our editor. Now, once we are inside of the editor, we're going to explore the basic functions, such as adding bold, italic, and styling text and background color. So to do that, we can simply click inside of the text field here. And once I click inside of this text field, I can highlight the text that I want to customize, and here we have the bold, the italic, and some different styling options so we can really customize this just the way that we want. We also have the link feature so that we can link this information to other parts of the web, maybe to our website, our email address, or so forth. So I highlighted my name, then I can click on the link option here to insert a link if I wanted to make my name redirect to somewhere else. I can also do the same thing with the image. I can click on the LinkedIn image and then click on the insert link option and link it to my LinkedIn page. Same thing for YouTube, Instagram, my logo, and so forth. We can link anything that we want. Now let's talk about linking your phone number, your email address, and your website. So the phone number and the email is going to be a little bit different. We are going to click inside of the phone number field here. We are going to highlight the phone number just like so. Then we're going to click the insert link option. Then we're going to enter TEL followed by a colon, then followed by your phone number. Now, anytime someone clicks this phone number link inside of your signature, it's going to automatically open up to call you with that phone number. So we're going to insert that just like so. Next up for the email address, let's go ahead and highlight all of this. And then we're going to go to insert link. And this time we're going to say mail to colon followed by your email address just like so. So mail to colon, then your email address, and then we're going to insert that. So now anytime someone clicks on your email address, it's going to open up their email app preloaded with your email address ready to send you an email. Last but not least, let's highlight our website here. Click on the insert link option. And for this one, we want to start it with https://, followed by your website URL, just like so. And then we click on insert. And now anytime someone clicks on your website, they're going to be redirected to your website instantly. What if you want to change the color of your links? No problem at all. Let's highlight our website here. And we're going to go to the color option here for text color. And we can make that whatever we want it to be, just like so. And if you don't like that, that's okay. We can highlight it once again and then change the color to anything that we want, just like so. It's that simple. Now, when you are making changes to your signature, you want to be sure to save your signature here and there just so you don't forget and you don't lose any of the changes that you made. So let's go ahead and name this signature. I'm going to call this my signature. And I'm going to go ahead and save my signature just so I don't forget. Now that we have it saved, we can come back in here and continue editing the signature however we'd like. For example, let's say that I wanted to link my image to my website. So when they click on my image, it goes directly to my website. So I'm going to click on my image. And then once I do that, as you guessed, we're going to go inside of the insert link and we're going to go https colon /, and then my website URL, and then click on insert. Now, anytime someone clicks on my image inside of my signature, they're going to be redirected to my website. And same thing goes with our social media icons down here at the bottom. For the LinkedIn, we're going to go to insert link, and I can insert my LinkedIn profile here. Same thing for YouTube, and same thing for Instagram. Now, it is essential to make your links visually appealing inside of your email signature so they are easy to spot. So if you are building this from scratch, you want to consider adding these icons in front of your phone number, your email, your website, just like we've done here, so that they stand out and catch the attention of the person reading your email. Now, directing our attention back to the social media links, if you are using a template like I am here, let's say that you don't have an Instagram account. Instead, you have a different account like Facebook. We can actually click on the icon, and then we can go to Image Gallery on the left-hand side and click on that. Then once we do that, we can then go to Icons and click on that. And we have a variety of different icons that we can select. So let's say that I was using Facebook. Now we have different styles for Facebook as well. We have a colorful Facebook, we have a black and white Facebook, and so forth. So let's go ahead and go with this one here. And I'm gonna click on the little plus symbol, and that's gonna change the icon for me, as we can see. Now we can also see it's a little bit bigger than the other icons. So I can click on the Facebook icon once again, then I can click on the ruler to change the size. And once I do that, we can change this to, I believe the other ones are 25 by 25. So let's try that and click on update. And we can see how that looks. Now, if I wasn't sure what the other sizes were, I could click on those, go to change size, and I can see those sizes as well. So now that we have our Facebook icon, I can update these icons as well to match the Facebook. So we'll go to the icons once again, and that one was YouTube. So now I will choose the YouTube icon, as we can see, and then we just have to adjust the size just like we did for Facebook. And then we'll choose update for that, and then I could do the same thing for my LinkedIn. Again, once we make all of these changes, be sure to save your project up here so that we don't lose any of the changes that we've made. Something else you can do with these icons, besides using them just for social media, is that we can even use this for a shared URL from Google Maps. So let's say that you wanted to share the location of your business. We can click inside of here. We'll change the image gallery. We'll go to icons here, and then we'll change this to a pin, for example, from Google. We'll change the size to 25. And then for the URL, we'll go inside of insert link, and then we'll insert the URL of our Google Maps location, because you can grab a URL from Google Maps. And we'll insert that in there and click on insert. And now, anytime someone clicks on the pin drop icon inside of our signature, it'll open up our location inside of Google Maps. Again, let's make sure that we save that since we made changes. All right, so now let's talk about tracking the performance of your email signature. Now, this allows you to track the clicks and gather valuable insights from people engaging with your signature. So after you have created your signature and you saved it, we can actually integrate with Google Analytics. Now, the way that we can do that is go to More up here at the top and click on that. Then we want to click on Integrations. And once we do that, that's going to bring us to our integrations screen. And as you can see, we have Google Analytics. We can click on this, click on Manage, and then we simply fill out the source and the medium for our Google Analytics, and then click on Save. Now, going back inside of our integrations, you can also use Bitly and shorten the links of all the items being used inside of your signature, okay? But now, let's talk about how to actually use the signature that we've created. So to do that, we are going to click on Signatures at the top left here, and we can see the one that we created, My Signature. Now, from here, all we have to do is click on Paste in Email. And once we do that, that's going to bring us back inside of our signature. And you'll notice when I move my mouse over these links, you can see they're actually hyperlinks just like we configured, and they are clickable. So from here, we can copy signature. And now we have it copied, and now we can paste it inside of our email as our email signature. We can also come to the bottom here and copy the HTML. So we can copy the code just like so, and then paste that into our email as well as our email signature. Lastly, we can even download the signature at the top right here and download the HTML content as well. To sum it all up, today we explored the world of mastering HTML signatures with clickable links. We discussed the importance of HTML signatures in professional communication, the benefits they offer, and how to create them using the By Brand Editor. Remember, HTML signatures enable you to make a lasting impression and easily connect with others. So, why wait? Start implementing HTML signatures with clickable links and take your email communication to the next level.